Hi, in this video I will show you how you can get your own webshop up and running, one of the cheapest and easiest ways. This webshop will be a medusajs webshop. It is an e-commerce solution comparable to Shopify and WooCommerce. So it will give you a webshop and an admin dashboard where you can manage your products, your orders and all that. Just like WooCommerce, but unlike Shopify, medusajs is open source, which means that it is free to use. However, you have to host it yourself, and hosting is not free. As far as I'm aware, it's not possible to get free hosting these days. But in this video, we'll be using Railway's hobby plan for hosting, and that costs as little as $5 per month, which is very cheap. So, what does the webshop look like, you might think? Here's an example. This is a screenshot, but I can also show you the live example. This is a webshop I made to sell some t-shirts. It is very simple, and I only have a few products right here. Let's go into one of them. This will be your product page. There is some different media you can upload. You can choose colors, sizes, and these are out of stock, unfortunately. Before we get started with the tutorial itself, I will have to mention that this video will be split in two parts. The first one, this video will only be going through how to host the medusajs webshop itself. So by the end of this video, you will have a template webshop. In the next video, I'll show you how you can make customizations to your webshop and personalize it. All right, let's get started with the tutorial. I'll scroll down a little bit, and here on step one, you'll see the requirements to get started. You will need a GitHub account and you'll need a Railway account. And I already have both, but I'll show you what you need to do. You go to GitHub. And I'm already logged in, but you have to, if you don't already have a GitHub account, you have to create one and then log in. Once you're logged into GitHub, head back to the blog post, click the link to Railway. You say log in, and then it's important that you choose the GitHub button because you need to connect the Railway account with GitHub as Railway will be maintaining a GitHub repository. All right, so once you are logged into Railway, you will see a banner, a yellow banner saying you are on a trial plan. And on the trial plan, you are not able to host the Medusa webshop. So you need to upgrade your plan to the hobby plan, which is the $5. It is very straightforward. Once you are on the hobby plan, you can go back to the tutorial, scroll down a little bit. Yeah, so here, this is what it looks like when you visit the website for the first time. It says you're on the limited trial for $5, and this is not sufficient to run the medusajs app. So you need to choose a plan, the hobby plan. Next thing is to deploy, and I created a deploy template to make it easy. I found it very confusing to host Medusa at first, and I spent some time getting it possible to host it on Railway. And I made a one-click deploy template, and yeah, some people used it already and had issues with it and asked me to make a tutorial, and this is why I'm making this video. So what you want to do is click the deploy on Railway button, and you're taken to the template. You can see it consists of a backend and a frontend, and the backend actually also hosts a frontend. It hosts the admin dashboard. So the admin dashboard will look something like this. This is where you have your products and can manage them. And the front end is the webshop I showed you a minute ago. Then there is a Postgres database and a Redis instance, and that's all. You want to click deploy. And this, yeah, so we have to do a little bit of configuration, but I have pre-configured the most for you. So if I expand this one, you'll see this is the backend part and the other one says the frontend part. But these are actually going to be merged into a mono repository. So instead of calling this one backend and this one frontend, I'm just going to rename it and say Medusa on Railway Demo. And I toggle on private repository because I don't want my source code to be publicly available to everyone. There is some environment variables here, and you don't have to worry about them yet. So you just click save. Yeah, so you see this one doesn't have a name anymore because the name of the repository was defined in this one. All right, so both are saved. when you have two green check marks, you can click deploy. You'll be taken to your Railway canvas. And yeah, it just said creating your product project. This will take a while. You'll get a name up here. I got Psychedelic Hook. And in a minute or so, it will start building the different elements. So that would be the database and the Next.js apps. I'll post the video and come back as soon as it's ready. All right, so now our canvas is populated with all the different blocks. You can see they are all in the building phase right now. Usually the Postgres database and the Redis is very fast to complete, but the backend and the frontend will take up to 10 minutes. Let's go into the backend one. You can see here under deployments that a build is in progress. It's elapsed only 30 seconds, so it will take quite a bit longer. Go to the settings tab. So here you'll see a source repo, and this is a repository in my GitHub. You'll have one in your GitHub, because when you used the deploy template, Railway created a Git repository where your source code is. So if you click on this one, you'll be taken to your own GitHub, and this is where you now have a clone of the boilerplate template that I made. And in the README, you can see here is a link to the step-by-step tutorial. So if you click this one, you'll come back to the blog post where all the information that you might need is. Okay. You can also see here upstream report. This is the boiler template that it was cloned from. I might make updates to this in the future. So by updating via the upstream repo, you'll get updates. So if medusajs updates, I know there has just been released a version 1.2 recently. I might update it, and then you should be able to update it using the check for updates button. Yeah, I'll pause the video and come back as soon as the rest of the app is finished building. I see the Postgres and the Redis is ready, but these two, they will take a while. So see you in a bit. All right, so that took quite a bit longer than expected. It's been now 14 minutes and the backend just finished. The frontend is still building, and that's because the frontend has to wait for the backend to finish. So there's still a little bit of building time left on the front end, but the backend is finished. And while we wait, I want to show you how you access your admin dashboard, because that's hosted from the backend. So if you go to the deployments, you have now this public URL that you can click on, and you'll see, okay, so it's actually not ready yet. This happens sometimes. When your Railway dashboard says something is ready, it's not always ready. It can take up to a minute or two. So we'll wait a little bit again. Okay, it's been another minute. I'll try again. And you'll see error again, but this is the error that we want to get. So the public URL is just the endpoint for the backend, but to access the dashboard, you have to add a little bit to the URL. So you say /app and hit enter. And now you'll see you're actually loading your admin application. It will ask you for login credentials, and the database has been seeded with some demo data. So there is actually already an admin user. If you go back to the tutorial and scroll all the way to the bottom, see, here is the login credentials for the demo admin user. So I'll copy that. And the password is super secret. I'll hit enter. I don't want to save, and I'm not going to give them my email. All right, this is your admin dashboard. If we go to products, you'll see there is already some products. These are Medusa demo data. So I am not going to show you how to use the admin dashboard and set up all your products, but I suggest that you delete all the demo products and start adding your own. If you want to get information on how to set up products, it is pretty straightforward, but there is a lot of YouTube tutorials how to do that, or you can simply find the official documentation by searching medusajs, go to the docs, And in here, there is documentation for everything you need to know, basically. It's a little bit technical, but you should be able to manage. All right, let's go back to Railway and see if our front end is finished. Not quite yet. I'll pause the video and come back as soon as the front end is finished. Yes, the front end is finally done. 23 minutes. Let's see if we have our app. We do. So this is now the template application, and let's open the menu, go to store, and you'll find the demo data that was populated when the database was seeded. So your products will appear in here. There is one last thing that we need to set up still before you can really start adding products. I'll close this one and I will go back to the tutorial and scroll up a little bit to add media storage. So one thing you need to understand with Railway is that every time your application is deployed, it builds it all over again. Your data will be kept in the database because the database is in a separate container and is not rebuilt. But if you add images in your app, they will be saved on the disk where your backend container is, and the backend container will be rebuilt. So you will lose your images. That's why we need an external media storage service. And I like to use Cloudinary. So I will go over to Cloudinary and I will sign up for free. And thankfully, we can just continue with GitHub. You will have to navigate to Programmable Media. And this information is what we need. We need your cloud name, your API key, and your API secret. Let's head back to Railway. You need to go to your backend container. Then go to variables, and we need to add three variables in order to use Cloudinary. And the easiest way to do that would be if we navigate back to the GitHub repository and we expand the backend product, and there is medusaconfig.js, and I scroll down a little bit. So these are the process, environment variables that we're going to need. So I'll copy them one by one. Copy this one. Variables, and I'm not going into the raw editor. I'll add them one by one. So cloud name, and then back to Cloudinary, copy cloud name, back to Railway, paste in that, add it. I'll add one more. So this one, that would be the API key. And we go to Cloudinary and we copy the API key. Paste that in, add. I now have two changes. We need to add the last one. And that would be the API secret. Go to Cloudinary and copy the secret. So now we have three changes. There is one last thing I want to do as well. So the JWT secret and the cookie secret, you should change those as well. Let's change them to something unique. Change this value, it says. I'll just write some random numbers. You can put in whatever you want. Just have to be unique for you. And in this one, I'll put some random letters. Now I have five changes and I'm going to click deploy and the backend will start redeploying. I'm going to pause and come back when it's done. All right, the changes to the environment has been deployed. At least it says it's finished. Let's test that it actually worked. So we go back to the admin app and let's refresh it. We were locked out, and that's because we changed the JWT secret. So our session token is now invalid. That's why we were locked out. Okay. Products. And in order to test that we are now using Cloudinary, I'm going to add a dummy product. This is one easy way of adding a media. And let's just go straight to the media, maybe a thumbnail. So I click browse and I have an image of my cat in a spacesuit. So I'll add that. And I probably need to give it a title. Let's see if this is enough. I'll click publish. Yeah, it looks like it. Let's go to the webshop. Go to the store. We now have a cat. I will inspect this image, and what we want to see is that this says something with Cloudinary. So what does the URL say? Yeah, so I find Cloudinary in this URL. You can see right here, cloudinary.com. So it's now hosted on the external media storage instead of on the railway disk. So if we were to redeploy our app, if there is an update, if we want to make a customization, basically anything that redeploys it, this image will now persist. It will be there again. Yeah, this is all for this tutorial. You can go ahead and add products and all that now. But if you want to make customizations, for example, you don't want your webshop to say Medusa Store, you want your own logo. I'll show you in the next video tutorial how to make changes, how to customize it and style it as you want. It is going to be very technical. So if you're not familiar with web development and Git and don't know how to write JavaScript, this is probably not for you, to be honest. Either you'll have to spend a lot of time learning web development, or you need to hire a web developer to make the changes for you. But I hope this tutorial helped you at least to host your webshop, and I hope that you'll add some products. And yeah, that's all for now.